So 2023 has been kind of a big year for us. There's been a lot of sort of things that have come to fruition, and
there was like a lot of like wonderful memories on the writing front, on the community front, on the travel front. And we asked for some questions, like a quick Q&A and stuff, and we got quite a few interesting questions.
Let's dive in.
All right, we got a question here from Road and Dirt. What made you want to start mountain biking?
Well, I mean, my best friend was a cyclist in high school, and I was in grade 11, and I was like, that looks fun. Let's go try that. And yeah, it was fun.
So what year was that?
That was in 1998. Yeah. Your turn to answer the question.
I got into mountain biking. Actually, my first mountain biking experience, I didn't even have a mountain bike. Judy from Color the Trails asked me to come out and film their intro to mountain biking course. And I just ran along with the other mountain bikers with a camera. And I was kind of intrigued by just how much fun it seemed like people were having. COVID hit and there was like a shutdown on all indoor things and everyone was encouraged to do outdoor activities. I thought, you know, let's give mountain biking or trail riding a try. So that was fall of 2020 and here we are now. All right, it looks like there's a bunch of people asking the same or similar question on dual suspension bikes in our future. Are we planning on going full squish? If yes, what would it be and why? And there's quite a few of you. So, all right, you wanna go first on this?
Well, I started riding on a hardtail and that was great. And then I did try a full squish for, I guess it was about a year. I just didn't really enjoy it that much. I just didn't feel comfortable. And I tried a Tiotin. And I was like, this is amazing, and I need to ride this bike. And it's been like, I would never go back.
Never?
Sorry. Never.
Never. Never, ever,
I'm just not into it. I'm not into it. I'm sorry. That's a hard no. A hard tail no. Steve?
Well, I've definitely tried full suspension bikes. Not seriously, though. I was in two photo shoots or video shoots where I had to ride a full squish bike. And it just didn't feel that comfortable. It was all over the place. The thing is, I'm having so much fun on a hardtail, and you know, it's like, why, what was it? Don't fix what ain't broke, right? So I've got a hardtail, I've got it dialed. I mean, I'll probably try something, but not out of like switching out, just maybe out of curiosity or something. Like I tried a rigid bike once. I think we were gonna try a single speed soon. So sure, I'll try a full squish again, seriously, but in terms of like owning one, nah, I love my bike too much. All right, so this one here from VGodX. What is one of the goals you're most proud of achieving this year, mountain biking or otherwise?
Wow.
Good question.
Why don't you go first, Steve?
Oof, wow, so many. So one of the goals that I set for myself this year was I was gonna ride this feature that Andy Fisher made called the Scolio Coaster on Lower Crippler on Mount Frome. Work of art, seeing my friend, coach, and just all-around badass mountain biker Jacqueline ride it just countless times. And I said, one day I will learn how to ride the Scolio Coaster. And you know, that day came, and I remember that morning where I said to Jacqueline, I'm like, Jacqueline, today I'm going to try to ride this. I remember riding into it, and you know, Jacqueline had a lot of information. I didn't make it the first time or the second time, not even the third time, I think. But you know, each time that I've fallen, I kind of pick myself up, listen to what it was that, you know, kind of contributed to the mistake or what I can do better next time. And I remember going over that second hump, that crux of the second hump, and then seeing the third and kind of like the curve as it went to the right. And it was just, whew, that was a trip. What about you? What's your goal or proud goal achievement moment for 2023?
Oh, wow. A goal that I had was to track stand to get good at track standing. I felt like there's a place for that in riding, and I was like, I'm gonna get good at this, you know? And I feel like I did. Here's a better one. Okay, I've been just in my mind, just, oh, I couldn't get over the roll on lower digger, you know, that bottom, it's just got a beautiful turn. There's nothing to be scared of at all, but it was just in my head and I just couldn't do it, but I did do that. And now I just do it every time. It's amazing.
Amazing. Have you ever been on a ride where you would have preferred to be riding a full suspension bike? Another full suspension bike question, you guys. Do you know what channel this is? It's not Full Squish Life. I mean, the short answer is no. I mean, there's nothing that I've ridden that needs a full suspension bike that couldn't have been solved with just better riding. So that's my take. Hardtail, all the way. Okay, here we go. One from our friend Mike. What were some of your highlights for 2023? Wow, this is a big question. Where do we even start?
Can I go first?
Yeah.
Okay. Visiting 5 places outside of Vancouver to ride mountain bikes.
Oh, wow. That's a lot.
Yeah.
I'm going to quickly... Okay, where did we go? We went to Kimberley, where we were not only photographers for our good friends who had a wedding, who got married, we did a quick photo shoot and stuff, but we also did their mountain biking photos the same day, right? So it's Kimberley.
You can tell what was most important to Steve, the wedding or the mountain?
We the
did
friends,
the mountain
the
biking photos and the wedding, but mountain biking photos.
And the friends.
Multiple days.
Congratulations, Carrie and Carly. Love you guys. Where else did we go?
Cumberland.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Big shout out to Jacqueline for organizing the Cumberland trip and to everyone who was there. That was, oh, so good. Even though we were like soaked to the bone days 2, 3, and 4. Actually, day 4 wasn't too bad. Yeah, that was a huge, huge trip.
Whistler?
Right? Oh, wow. Okay, highlight. We are sponsored Nolly Riders. We're, what do you call it? Regional athletes. We're regional athletes for Nolly. That's huge.
Steve's a regional athlete.
Like, have you seen who rides for Nolly? Like, of course, they're not adding us to the roster for our abilities, riding abilities. They're adding us, I don't know what they're adding it for, but.
As the every man and woman's inspiration, right? The person who's getting started and wants to progress, right?
That is true.
You know?
Mountain biking is not just for senders. It's not just for people who ride blacks. It's for everyone. You can ride at whatever speed, whatever trail, whatever altitude, and walk and ride and do whatever you want as long as you're having fun and being safe.
You can bumble along.
Absolutely. Oh, nice one. another place we rode was Sunshine Coast, right? Thanks to our good friends Warren and Mike who made it happen. We got to ride Sunshine Coast, and we not just Sunshine Coast, but trails from the builders that are not easily or publicly available. So that was like a VIP experience for sure. Well, so you said 5 places. I only named 4. Victoria. Heartland, baby. Meg, what's your favorite trail in Heartland?
Well, now it's 90s Jank. But it used to be Snakes and Ladders.
90s Jank is so good.
Yeah. It's so good. Oh, it's so good. And we have to go back and ride. Well, I'm not going to ride it. Well, maybe. But that slab.
Where is this?
Just, you know, when you rode the section of Jank at the end of 90s Jank, it's right at the end.
Okay, whatever it is, we're coming back. So, mountain bikers of Victoria, you've heard us. We are coming back. Shout out to Sims. All right.
And that's 5, right?
Yeah.
Whistler, Cumberland, Kimberley, Sunshine Coast, Victoria.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm. It would be lovely to, in 2024, it'd be lovely to go visit other little communities. I'm not talking like Whistler or Squamish. Like, everyone knows Whistler and Squamish. But, like, I don't know, like, we have friends in Golden that we would need to visit.
Yeah, and like Pemberton, I heard is really good.
I swear, like, there's so much between here and Kimberley.
Here, but like going all the way around the world.
Yeah.
Yeah, like here again.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. yeah, that would be pretty awesome to ride somewhere outside of Canada as well. So I don't know, maybe we can make it happen. Okay, just wish for it. Just close your eyes and wish for it for a second.
Another memorable thing that I did was my first race as an adult. And it was I raced my first fiver. There's so many incredible riders out there. And yeah, so I'm definitely gonna partake in those fun rides.
Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, another highlight of 2023 is just going to the Tuesday morning rides with Andrew, Penny, and Jacqueline. Just, you know, whether we're pushing up Pipeline or pushing up Pink Starfish or pushing up, there's a theme here. Whether we're riding Pipeline or Lower Crippler or Pipeline or
and Lower Crippler.
You know, those have been amazing. I also feel like another highlight of 2023, it felt like a big year of progression, like getting feedback from people I ride with and saying that, oh, you're quicker or you're, you know, your body positioning is better on your bike and stuff. And oh, you know what? I feel like I have owe a lot to Untamed training or Untamed race team training by Essential Cycles and Color the Trails. Actually, I believe that they're starting a new intake for 2024. So if you want to up your mountain biking skills, this is a really good way to do that.
And we'll be there,
yes,
learning more.
We're coming back for more.
Yeah, and shooting, of course.
You bet.
Yeah. So one thing about 2023 that I felt like was so amazing and rewarding was like developing community and getting to know different groups better, like the Shore Sirens, and still working with Color the Trails and with Essential Cycles.
Mm-hmm. And working, you know, like still with the NSMBA, with Noli.
There's some really special moments, like that we got to make some videos with Nick from Van Can. And we got to, you know, just do a variety of different things with different people.
We are so, so blessed to have those relationships, to be able to build them, and we're all just working together to make mountain biking just more rad. So, another question that we got is, what are some goals that you're aiming for next year? You have any goals for next year?
I do, but I'm almost nervous to like even speak them. But I would like to roll over a lot of things on Mount Frome, including Big Smooth.
Big Smooth, that was a big one. And you
know
what?
I had to work up to saying it out loud.
I feel like you're pretty close.
So I am going to be really focusing on Unteam training, like push-ups or whatever they make you do with kettlebells at the beginning. And yeah, there's so much to learn. I also would like to work on my racing this year, and I would like to tackle the Whistler. I would like to tackle saying the word Whistler. Whistler back 40.
Whoa, you heard it here, folks. Meg's gonna do the Whistler back 40.
Yeah, so, yeah.
All right, big year for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, what about you, Steve?
Well, I mean, we rode in 5 places outside of our like North Shore area. I like to do another 5 in 2024. I think it'd be great to just keep growing the channel, right? Keep building that community, keep talking about hardtails, keep trying, maybe we'll try a few other hardtails. I don't know, maybe we hosted one hardtail ride and hardtails and hardtail friends. Maybe we'll try to do a few more of those, because
cool.
I mean, we had a lot of fun. All right, well, thanks for all your questions and your interest. And if you're relatively new to riding, but you love it and you want to do it all the time, then you've come to the right place.
We're eager to ride all the trails and learn all the things. So please subscribe and follow along on our mountain biking adventures.
Thanks for watching and
see you in the trails.
It caught it.